Get the legends on there, you know, like Patrice Rushen, you know, she's the star of the show, you know. So it's an honor to, you know, be out on the road and play with her, and also Allison Williams. You know, we got all the OGs, you know, the hardcores who contribute to the music to we listen to today. You know, that's it. So I'm just happy to be in the moment, be in now, and you know, yeah, it's been a fun tour.
You've been around a long time anyway. You've been doing this a long time.
Yes, I have. Yes, I have.
You've been really successful with the collaborations as well.
Yep. Yeah. It's I enjoy collaborating and you know, just having fun. You know, being able to work with different artists and different calibers, and you know, it just brings a lot out of me and as well as them.
Yeah, that's true.
Mm-hmm.
It must be.
Yeah.
You worked with before we go far. You worked with Mos Def. How
was it? That was cool. That was like some Black Rock Coalition thing, yeah. You know, back in the day. You know, so. Yeah, it was a fun one thing. That was it. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. What have you been working on recently? What was your last
book? Recently, I've been doing stuff with Verna Reed from Living Color. Oh. Yohembe, we do the Yohembe Brothers project. I've been working with my project, Project Logic, and some great young musicians. Been working with Keon Harold, Jalil Shaw, Mono Neon, my partner Casey Benjamin, you know, Marcus Gilmore, and also had Vernon part of that as well, and
great
guitarist from Living Color, yes, and who's my, you know, my brother and mentor, and James Hurt, you know, so did a little run with that, and also did some stuff with Daru Jones and Mono. Did another, that was like a trio thing. You know, just trying to find different things, you know, that keeps me evolving, interesting, motivating, and fun. You know, that's what it's all about.
How did you begin with DJing? How did that come to you?
It was just all a hobby. I just started, you know, I was admired by my peers before me, you know, and I was always a big hip-hop fan, and growing up in the Bronx, you know, where it all happened at, you know, I had all that music around me, and I just kind of just, you know, just got sucked into it, and it was something that really, you know, something I really enjoyed, you know, that I wanted to do, you know, watching and seeing the DJ conduct and watching the audience vibe off of what the DJ was spinning. I was like, that's something I want to do, you know, be kind of like the playlist in a way, you know, creating the people's soundtrack, creating their fun, you know, so, and who doesn't like to have fun, you know, who doesn't like to party and stuff like that, so, you know, and it's always great to discover new music, to, you know, present to people, you know, to keep them going on the dance floor, new rhythms and things like that. So, you know, I just try to, you know, just keep it entertaining. Mm-hmm.
Bronx has changed a lot now over the years, isn't it?
Are
you still there?
Yeah, the Bronx has changed a lot. I mean, all of New York has changed a lot. And, I'm still in my neck of the woods and, you know, very proud of it, you know, and you know, it inspires me because, you know, the culture and stuff, so, and just New York in general, so things are over. It's been, you know, everything's revolving all over the world, you know, so yes, I do. I travel a lot.
Yeah, that's unusual.
Mm-hmm.
You get that much time to travel.
Yeah. Right.
You know, that's close by. They're 40 miles away from each other.
Yes.
I wouldn't like to walk that distance.
No, I wouldn't like to walk that distance either. Yeah.
I forgot who were you working with in Vienna.
In Vienna, I think it might have been with Graham Haynes, maybe. Yeah, I think I was working with Graham Haynes on his project, and you know, it's not the first time I ever played in Vienna. You know, I played the jazz festival there. I was there with the Miles Electric Band. I've done stuff with Wallace Rooney, Buster Williams, Benny Maupin. Doug Karn, Antoine Rooney, who else is on that gig? Al Foster, you know, so yeah, and that was special, and also playing in that venue is an amazing venue. So
Buster Williams,
yeah, they're all legends. Yeah. So, you know, being the young guy, a part of that was great.
And Buster in Vienna.
Right. Yeah, he's awesome. He's an awesome guy to sit down with and just, you know, kind of like pick his brain on all the, you know, so much information from that era of, you know, when he was coming up and just into now, you know. So it's special to get the opportunity to play with those guys as well as talk to them, you know. And I do a lot of stuff with the Miles Estate, with Vince Wilburn. And Vince Wilburn and Aaron and Cheryl Davis, and you know, I worked with them on their Miles Electric Band thing as well. Mm-hmm. So you know, and a lot of different variations of different groups, you know, around that Miles you know, vibe and stuff. So, you know, Miles always kept it revolving.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. And then I did a thing at Newport with Christian, and that was part of the Philadelphia experiment. That was with Questlove, and Yuri Kane, and as well as with Christian and Yuri Kane, Questlove, and Christian and myself. Yeah.
What's his name, Doug?
Oh, Fife. Yeah, that was terrible. He was, you know, he was dealing with the unfortunate, you know, thing, and it was just a terrible loss to the hip-hop community, and, you know, he's always remembered, you know, as the 5-foot assassin, and, you know, and he always had the amazing lyrics and bars and quotes and stuff that everybody, you know, remembered, and, you know, and he was a good supporter, good brother, you know, he was a good brethren. Man.
That's right. Questlove was one from Roots, isn't it?
Yes, Questlove. Yep. Yeah.
Yeah, they've done very well too, the Roots. Have you done
the Roots as well? I've done stuff individually, you know, with different guys from Black Thought to Hub, my boy Mark, who's playing bass now with them, Kurt, you know, each individual guy I've done something with in the past. Mm-hmm. And you know, and I followed them through the years, you know, them coming out of Philly, you know, and they were working with a lot of great jazz people as well, who, you know, from Cassandra Wilson to Graham Haynes, you know, I was a big fan, and to this day I still am, and they're still keeping it real, and, you know, and they haven't changed, and they still know how to put on a great, great show, and, you know, I'm proud of them. Well, I got into music in general, like, you know, it was being played around my household, you know. My moms would play, you know, the Miles Davis to John Coltrane, and Aretha Franklin and James Brown. Yeah, it was, the music was around me, and you know, I got involved with the jazz guys. I had a friend who was a drummer, Rich, and he, you know, he thought it'd be cool to come down and play with his band, and I was like, okay, I'll do that, you know, not thinking of anything. I just kind of wanted to just try, be open-minded, you know, so what I had to lose, you know, being young and curious. And, you know, I just went downtown to one of the cool jazz clubs called the Knitting Factory.
Oh, yeah.
And I met this wonderful guy, Melvin Gibbs. And also, I think Brandon Ross was on there, mm-hmm. and might have been Graham Haynes too at the time. Yeah, it was like that whole downtown contingent, and it was also part of the whole Black Rock Coalition too. Yeah. So they had an improv show, and you know, they invited me to join them, mm-hmm. and it was me. Basically, that was like my introduction of improvisation to jazz, and learning how to, you know, play, look at my turntables as an instrument and play like a musician, you know, basically listening to what was going on around me. And from me listening to all those older records like the Miles and Weather Report and John Coltrane, you know, I picked up some of those little things from those records that, you know, I kind of wanted to create my own little thing, you know, around those sounds that I was hearing, like the atmospheric effects and things like that, you know. If it was a certain instrument that wasn't there, you know, I would just find that sound, like I'll put it in, like a trumpet sound with a little delay. And yeah, I was just being creative. You know, there's a skill to that, and you know, and you know, you also learning how to play with others, you know, and paying attention, and you know, and basically just, you know, showcasing your talent.
It's amazing.
It is, and it's fun, you know. It gives you a challenge to, you know, figure out things and how to be able to. Yeah. It was a little nervous, you know. So, but once I got into it, it felt right in, and I felt comfortable. That was it. Mm-hmm.
Christian
came to me and he had this amazing idea he wanted to do, and we also wanted to work together, you know. He was talking about wanting to work together, and he was just like, hey, man, I have this idea. It's called The Situation. I want to bring you and Patrice, and I think we also had Oliver Lake, and I'm not sure who else was there. Oh, and Ron Blake, and who else? Yeah, it was just his configuration of ideas of just trying to experiment on something that was a situation,
right.
You know. So, and I thought it was very cool and a great idea. And when he told me who the people were involved, I was just like, it was a no question.
Yeah.
I was like, Patrice Russian,
yeah.
Wow, of course, amazing. You know, amazing. Mm-hmm. You know, I have all her records. Mm-hmm. I dance to her records. Mm-hmm. I enjoy listening to her records. So it was special, you know, to, you know, be a part of the group. And, you know, we've been doing it for probably over 10 years now. About 10 years, I would say, maybe. Yeah. And, you know, we work on schedules because he has his own thing. I have my own thing. So it's when, you know, everybody's schedule, you know, works out. Yeah, allows it, you know, and Patrice has her thing. So, But this is our first European tour.
Wow.
I'm very happy that, you know, we're bringing it over across seas,
yeah,
and everyone to see it, you know, because people have been hearing about it and seeing it, you know, on YouTube and
yeah,
all of this and that. So
here.
Now, yeah, so now we bring it to the masses.
Yeah.
We bring it across the pond.
Yeah.
So this is great. This is a great tour, and it's an honor to be out here with these guys, and we're having fun.
It's sold out. Yes.
Yeah, sold out. All the shows have been sold out.
Yeah.
All the shows have been sold out, and all the shows have been a great response, and it's good to see every age group, you know, coming out for the performance. And you know, it's working with Patrice, working with Jahi Sundance, Ron Blake, and also Allison William,
yeah,
great vocalist who's contributed to a lot of hip hop and R&B, you know. She's the, how you say it, she's the hip hop vocalist.
Yes.
Yeah, the queen of hip hop. No offense to Mary J. Blige, but Allison Williams, yeah, Allison Williams started that singing on top of the rap music and stuff like that. So, you know, people, do your homework, look up Allison Williams and you'll know what I'm talking about. But yeah, she was the first female artist to sign the Def Jam. So having Allison Williams and Patrice rushing out on
amazing.
Is amazing, you know. So we're all enjoying it, and everybody's bringing a lot to the table, and everybody's having fun.
Sure.
Yeah.
Yeah. We're done.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Good to see you again.
Yeah, you too.
Yes, sir.